Smith has got those tapes, and she's going to use them if I don't do as she says.
You're not going to let her get away with that, are you? You're a match for Smith.
Vera, we're in trouble if she uses those tapes. And if I'm living with you and it comes out, well, you'll be hauled into it as well.
What are you saying?
I'm moving out.
Why?
Vera, if I'm going down, I'm not dragging you down with me.
That's ridiculous.
Oh, let's face it, love. I'm nothing but trouble to you. I mean, why give Smith a double satisfaction?
I don't care about Smith. I care about you. I don't want to lose you. I'm not going to give you up just for this. We'll fight it, both of us. Please, Terry.
Vera, I'm finished. She's got me. Who knows how many copies of that tape she's got, or who's got them?
I'm not going to let Smith ruin our relationship.
Vera, I know what your career means to you. I have to go.
Terry.
Is that this morning's Age?
Yes.
Julie, I haven't had a chance to read it yet.
Now, it's the last time I'll be signing this thing.
What are you talking about?
Smith and those bloody tapes.
And to me, something else has happened.
Yeah, I suppose I should have told you the whole story in the first place.
Yeah, well, come on. What happened?
Oh, there's no reason why you shouldn't know now. I spoke to Smith. She's got a copy of the tape.
She wants something for it, right?
Oh, when she's good and ready, yeah.
And if you don't play ball, it'll end up on the governor's desk.
You guessed it.
Then if you do her a favour and she promises to give you back the tape, you can bet she'll have made a copy of it.
The old blackmail game.
Yeah, when it comes to getting blood out of a stone, Smith's an expert.
That's why I'm getting out. As long as she's got that tape, I won't be able to sleep at night.
8 years service down the drain, eh?
Can't say I wasn't warned.
Yeah, well, I'm going to miss you, mate. Bloke doesn't make many friends in a place like this.
My resignation will be on the governor's desk first thing in the morning.
I wish there was some other way.
Oh, we'll have a beer now and again.
Yeah, sure we will. Listen, I better get back to it.
Yeah, sure. I'll see you later.
Yes, sir, Terry. Vera, what's the matter?
Nothing.
Well, it doesn't sound like it. Come on, what's wrong?
I've just got something in my eye. This sore, that's all.
This wouldn't have anything to do with Terry, would it?
No, why should it?
Well, if the women see you like that, they'll just take advantage of you.
Yes, sir. I suppose you're right.
So at least rest in here until you can cope. Okay?
Jim, I've got some urgent business. Do you suppose I could have the afternoon off, please?
Yes, of course. I think we can cover for you.
Thank you. Really appreciate it.
Vera. Good luck, eh?
Thanks.
Would you check that number for me, please, Julie? I'm sure there's someone home, but there's no answer. Perhaps there's something wrong with the line. Oh, you're leaving us early, Miss Bennett.
Oh, yes, Mrs. Davidson, but it's all right. I've spoken to Mr. Fletcher.
Well, you don't look very well.
I'm just feeling a little off colour, that's all. Nothing serious.
Are you sure? Is there anything you'd like to talk about? Sometimes it helps to get your problems out into the open, even if they're personal.
Oh, no, Mrs. Davidson, I'll see how I'm feeling in the morning.
All right, good night.
Hi, Bee. Do you reckon Dave will let Lizzie come back yet? I'm really starting to miss her.
Well, I don't know. Anything's possible, but do you think she really wants to come back?
Well, she's without all her mates, isn't she? It must be awful for her.
What, in maternity, with all those babies around her?
Do you reckon she's missing us?
I don't think she's given us a second thought, Doreen. She got babies to hug and rattles to rattle. Now, you understand that, don't you?
Yeah, of course I do.
Yeah, if anyone goes gaga over babies, it's you.
Yeah, I know. Still miss her, though.
Yeah, I know, like we all do. Oh, come on, ladies, let's shut up shop.
Right, that's it for today, ladies. When you get cleaned up, go to the recreation room. All except you, Smith. I want a word with you.
Oh, but I'd hate to miss the evening news, Mr. Fletcher.
Why don't you have someone tape it for you first?
Oh, whatever do you mean?
Gaffney's blackmail tape. Hand it over.
I don't know what you're on about. Didn't Terry tell you I gave it back to him?
Come on, don't play dumb with me, Smith. I know you had it copied first.
Oh, I was just kidding. Got to make life in here interesting somehow.
I want that tape, Smith.
Well, I'd love to give it to you, Mr. Fletcher, if it existed.
Terry's a decent sort of bloke, you know. He's honest and he's straight.
Yeah, with someone who's paid to lock people up, I suppose he's not a bad bloke.
When someone blackmails him like this, we all suffer, you as well as us.
Oh, how's that?
Well, all sorts of people work in prison, Smith, as we both well know. You get your bad apples like...
Like
Jock Stewart. Mm. That's right. But when someone gets blackmailed like Terry is, the system has a habit of turning up a real louse to take his place. I'm sure you've seen it happen before.
Well, I'll tell you what I'll do, Mr. Fletcher. If I hear of anybody giving Terry a hard time, I'll let you know.
Hello. Dr. Vaughan, yes, put him through, please, Julie. Oh, hello, Doctor. I'm glad you called. I've been trying to... What? Good heavens.
She'd been telling me how ill she was, and I never really believed her. Now she's collapsed. A nurse found her by the phone.
Well, do you know what the trouble is?
Erica, I'm sorry. I can't talk to you. I'm calling from the hospital. I'd like you to come here as soon as you possibly can. They're going to operate right away. Your mother has a cerebral thrombosis.
Boy, what a way to go. What are you doing, hon?
Jim let me off early. I said I was feeling sick.
Yeah, you're not making it any easier. In fact, you're making it harder for both of us.
Look, Terry, you don't have to go. Please don't go.
I do have to go. If Smith gives that tape to the governor, all hell's going to break loose. I mean, Jim will be dragged into it, you'll be dragged into it. Look, we went through this in the staff room.
Terry, there's more to this than Wentworth. Please listen to me. You think that my job at the prison means everything to me, don't you?
It's a large part of your life, yes.
I thought so too. But that was before you came along. Surely you realize that. Look, a long time ago, I fell in love with a man who turned out to be a criminal.
You're kidding. Boy, you can really pick him, can't you?
Even after I knew all that, it didn't stop me loving him. Oh, Terry, please listen to me. I was ready to throw away my career, everything, just to be with him.
That's not going to happen this time.
I haven't let myself feel that way about anyone until now. Even if they sack you or drag your name through the mud, I'll stand by you, I promise.
I really mean that much to you?
Of course you do. Without you, there's nothing.
Yeah, well, you're not so bad yourself now I think of it. Mind you, I don't like to think about it.
Oh, Terry, please don't resign. Let's see if we can find a way.
Oh, I don't know. While Smith's got that tape, there's not much I can do about it. Besides, I promised Jim I'd have my resignation on the governor's desk tomorrow.
Let's try one more time. I hate the idea of Smith forcing you out.
Yeah, but I'm not too ramped on it either.
Let's fight back.
What, and get you the sack? No, look, I'll think about it, right? But you stay out of it.
On one condition.
What's that?
That you take the clothes out of the suitcase and stay.
Ah. Blackmail. I can't win, can I? No matter which way I turn, I'm blackmailed.
It's not blackmail. I'm just doing it for your own good.
For years now, I've been calling in on my way home, just to see how she was doing. Today, I was too busy. Damn it!
James.
Glad you were able to come so quickly.
How is she, Doctor?
She's not well, Erica. Would you sit down? Your mother has partial paralysis. difficulty speaking.
And the operation?
Well, maybe it could have been avoided. I was just saying to James, if only I'd taken her symptoms more seriously.
But she's had so many.
Well, of course, I was watching her blood pressure carefully and treating her various minor ailments. But with a stroke, well, there's often not much warning.
Doctor, for as long as I can remember, she's had every ache and pain imaginable.
She was always complaining. How anyone could pick out the serious symptoms, I wouldn't know.
Doctor, I think you've done a marvelous job just listening kindly and patiently to her over the years.
It's whatever happens. We know you've done your best.
Where is Mother now?
They're getting her ready for theatre. I've arranged for you both to see her before she goes in. I must warn you that this operation is not without risk, even for someone younger and fitter. But for a person in Florence's condition, it's very dangerous indeed.
What are her chances?
To be honest with you, less than 50-50.
Mother? It's Erica, Mother, and James is with me.
Now don't worry, Mother. You don't have to talk.
We're here, and you're going to be all right.
Going to die.
Nonsense. You mustn't talk like that.
You've got Dr. Vaughan and the very best surgeon. Now, no more of that kind of talk.
Mother, you're going to be all right. You're going to live. But the doctors can't do it alone. You have to keep your spirits up.
Sorry.
You have nothing to be sorry for. Come now, save your strength.
Sorry.
But why? Why do you keep saying you're sorry?
Ask Dr. Vaughan.
Ask Dr. Vaughan.
What did Fletch want to talk to you about? After work in the laundry.
Oh, the tape.
What'd you tell him?
Nothing. Then he gave me something to talk about.
Yeah, what?
Well, he reckons if Terry gets fired, we'll probably end up with someone really heavy in his place.
Well, what are we going to do?
Don't know yet. Tape's too good to waste. I'd like to get something out of it.
Yeah, I reckon.
Maybe we give it to Terry as a present.
You said we should get something out of it.
Yeah, well, like I said before, then he'd owe us one. Could come in handy.
Are you thinking of letting a screw off the hook?
Look, think about it, Doreen. If we ask Terry to bring stuff in for us and he won't, well, might as well throw the tape away and forget about it. Or...
or we bloody dob him in like we said we would.
No way. That way we get nothing. We'll probably get a lousier screw in his place.
Yeah, well, I say still dob him in. Let him off easy and they'll walk all over us.
No one's going to get off easy, Doreen. We want to handle this most sensible way possible so we get something out of it.
Yeah, well...
anyway, Terry's not such a bad bloke. Even if he has got rotten taste in women.
They've been in there for 2 hours. Why don't they tell us something?
Come on now. No point in us getting edgy.
She's still in theatre, I'm afraid.
Doctor, she was terribly upset before they took her in there. She was in tears and kept saying she was sorry.
She told us to ask you what that sorry meant.
Yes, well, I think I know what she means. Florence felt she was a failure as a mother, and she always worried about it.
But why?
Well, she was never at ease with children. And then something happened to take away the little bit of confidence that she did have. You weren't the firstborn, James. Florence had another little boy a year or so before you.
And something happened to him?
Yes, he had a bad fall and died of a brain hemorrhage. It was an accident that could have happened to anybody, but Florence blamed herself for it. And then when you two came along, she wouldn't trust herself with the child. She was always terrified of another accident.
Is that when she found a nanny for us?
That's right. And that's when started the parties, the charity work, anything to help her forget. And with old age, she found it very easy to hide behind her ailments.
I had no idea she thought of anyone but herself.
Only she talked about these things.
Yes, it would have made it so different.
And then when your marriage broke up, Erica, and you buried yourself in your work, she thought it was for much the same reasons that she, in her turn, had become a socialite.
She thought I was running away too.
Yes. And she blamed herself for all of it.
I've never really known her. My own mother.
Mrs. Davidson, Mr. Mahon.
How is she?
I wish I had good news for you. We did all we could, but your mother didn't survive the operation. I'm sorry.
Morning, Mr. Fletcher. Julie.
Good morning. This is the same person that went home sick last night.
Well, I don't feel like the same person.
Well, obviously that urgent business got done then.
It certainly did. Thank you very much for letting me off.
Oh, it's a pleasure. If all my sickies came back like you, I'd have no staffing problems. Now, Mrs. Davidson, you forgot to sign in.
Does it really matter, Mr. Fletcher? I am the governor of this prison, and I know that I am here. I don't want to be disturbed, Julie.
I've never seen Mrs. Davidson like that before.
Yeah, something must be wrong. I'd better find out what it is.
I'm glad it's you and not me.
Hi, B. What you doing?
Waiting for the maid to run my bath. What do you think I'm doing?
Oh, you're mad. Have you decided what to do with that tape yet?
No hurry. Oh, here we go again, folks.
Look, I was the one who stuck my neck out about that tape. I don't want it just being thrown away.
Will you quit worrying, Doreen? You're taking all the fun out of it.
Smith, you wait there. Burns, you're working in the laundry.
Oh, that'll make a real nice change, Miss Bennett.
Just get moving.
Hop the steam press up for me. I'd hate to miss a minute's work.
You're still blackmailing Mr. Harrison, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm trying to get a kiss after lights out.
I'm going to put a stop to your game.
And how do you plan to do that, Vera?
Because you're going to give me that tape.
Oh, am I just...
Because I promise you, you won't get a moment's peace day or night until you do.
You know, I'm getting tired of hearing this tape I'm supposed to have. If you think I've got it, search me. Come on, search me. Search myself. See if you can find it.
Smith, you come back here or you'll spend the next week in solitary.
What for?
Insubordination.
And I wonder what Davo would think of that.
You can go now, Smith. But believe me, you haven't heard the last of this.
What was that all about?
Oh, first Fletch, now Vera. You know, I'm getting sick to death of this.
She after the tape too?
Yeah. And thanks to Vinegar Tits, I have just decided what we're going to do with it.
Yeah?
We're going to screw her precious Terry for everything we can get.
Ooh. I gave instructions. I was not to be Oh, it's you, Mr. Fletcher. Can't wait.
Well, I know you like to keep up with new arrivals, Mrs. Davidson. We have a Michelle Parks due in on a charge of breaking an entry and theft of money.
Yes, well, I'll get the details later. Thank you.
Is there anything wrong, Mrs. Davidson? You don't seem your normal self.
No, you're right. I'm not my normal self, and I must apologize for my behavior out there.
Was there anything I can help you with?
No, I don't think so, thank you. It's... Well, someone close died, rather. Suddenly.
Oh, I'm sorry. Family?
Yes, my mother.
Oh, how awful. You must be feeling terrible.
It's just that I didn't expect her death to affect me like this.
Well, why don't you take some time off?
Go home? I wouldn't know what to do with myself.
No, you'd be better off there. Believe me, you've had a shock. I know how you feel.
Thank you, Jim, but I'm better off here keeping myself busy.
Well, there are things to do at home, aren't there? Relatives to notify, arrangements to make?
Yes, I suppose you're right.
And there's nothing that'll be happening this afternoon that I can't handle.
Thank you, Jim. I'm just not thinking straight.
She was sick for so long, and now she's gone. It all happened so quickly.
Smith, I want to speak to you.
Here I am.
Outside.
You see, girls? Popular. They all want to be alone with me. You know, I couldn't get more attention if I had Russian secret papers. First Fletch, then Vera, now you.
What do they want?
The same as you, the tape.
Yeah, but I don't want them getting involved, understand?
Then you keep your big trap shut. Your girlfriend's been giving me a hard time, and I don't like it.
All right, from now on, it's between you and me.
Yeah, well, so it should be.
Now, look, I'm prepared to do the odd favor for you on the outside. Take a bet for you, see a friend, maybe. But I want that tape, and I want to guarantee there are no copies.
It's worth more than that, and you know it. I want stuff brought in.
No way. I'm not going to be a courier.
Either you bring in what I say when I say, or that tape goes straight to the governor.
Well, we might as well go and see it right now, because I'm not trafficking for you.
Fair enough. That's the way you want it.
I can get into more trouble, and you just hang on to the tape.
Suit yourself.
Well, it was worth a try. Didn't really think you'd see it my way. Well, when I'm gone, you and the girls can play the tapes and have a good laugh.
Oh, quitting, huh?
Yeah, right now. In fact, you can come and see the governor with me if you like.
Hang on. Now, what's your hurry?
Well, there's no hurry. The sooner it's over, the better, that's all. Well, are you coming?
No, just a minute. Hold your horses. Well, we could do worse than you, I suppose. At least you crack a joke once in a while. Mind you, you'd have to have a sense of humour to be going out with Vera.
All right. No naughty remarks, okay?
Okay. So I'll give you the tape after lunch. And it is the only one.
Thanks.
Ooh. Oh, sorry.
Hey, didn't you come in this morning with a smile on your face?
Yes, that was this morning. Which reminds me, how did you get on with Mrs. Davidson?
Yeah, well, that's what I wanted to talk to you about. Her mother died last night.
Oh.
Yeah, she wasn't taking it too well, so I suggested that she go home.
Well, I know how she feels. It's a dreadful time.
Well, I think she'll be okay, but in the meantime, we've got a few problems of our own, haven't we? I suppose you know that Smith's got a copy of that tape.
Well, yes, I do know. How did you find out?
Terry told me.
Will you be telling the governor?
Oh, there's no need to. Mind you, I don't agree with what he did, but I don't see any point in making it public.
Yes, that's the way I feel too.
In any case, he's resigning today, so I'm willing to forget the whole thing.
Oh, well, I won't forget. It really makes me furious that one of those animals can force a good officer out of a job.
Agreed. But don't forget, he got himself into this.
Jim, he was cultivating informers. We've all done it, and we haven't had to resign, have we?
Vera, I know you've got a personal interest in this, but we can't afford to lose you, too. You realize that, don't you?
Yes, of course.
Now, you and I may not see eye to eye from time to time, but I happen to think that you're a very good officer.
Well, thank you. It's nice to be appreciated. Anyway, I don't have any plans at the moment. It all depends on what Terry decides to do.
How can that lot run after the lunch? I feel like I've eaten concrete.
Yeah. Well, it takes us years to get the goods on a screw like that, and you're just going to hand over that tape to him like it was a Christmas present.
Look, I told you if I didn't, he was going straight to hand in his notice, and I've explained that to you three times, Doreen.
Yeah, well, I know that I am not very bright, but I tell you what, I'm going to think twice before I ever hand anything over to you again.
Now, don't go getting cheeky. It was a nice, friendly thing to do, and the time will come when he will do a nice, friendly thing for us. What the hell?
Ah, Smith, there you are.
What do you want?
Look, we had a deal, remember?
Oh, yes, we had a deal, all right, but it's one rule for the screws, another one for us, isn't it?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't come that with me. It was either you or one of your mates.
What was?
You just couldn't wait, could you? Had to get one of your cronies in just to make sure, just in case.
What?
My cell, that's what, the one you ransacked.
Ransacked? Well, I didn't do it, I swear it.
Well, then who did?
I don't know. I suppose the tape's gone.
Yeah, along with a few other things.
Oh, that's very clever, Smith, yes. You ransack your own cell or get someone to do it for you, then you have an excuse to keep the tape.
Oh, no. No one else would be that stupid except a screw.
So, stalemate.
Looks like it, doesn't it?
Look, we had an agreement.
Yeah, and all I got out of it was a wrecked cell.
Well, it wasn't me.
Well, then you better find out who it was.
because they've got the tape.
Michelle Janice Parks, you're charged with breaking and entering the premises of G.C. Wilkins Mail Order Company and the theft therefrom of $8,000. Is that correct?
No, it isn't. I never did it.
What we want to know is whether the charge is correct or not. The jury will decide whether you're innocent or guilty.
Well, come on, Parks. Is the charge correct or isn't it?
Well, that's what I've been charged with, but I didn't...
Yes, yes, yes. No, you didn't apply for bail.
I couldn't. I didn't have the money and my family couldn't afford it.
You are remanded in custody until the date of your trial. Is that correct?
Yes.
Thank you, Constable.
When will I go to trial?
When a date's been set. Now go behind that screen and get ready for a shower.
But I had a shower this morning.
Don't argue, Parks.
I'm clean, I'm telling you.
You'll do as Miss Bennett tells you, and you'll hurry up about it. When you're finished, I'll come back and take you to your cell.
They never change, do they? They're all innocent, no matter what.
Come on, Parks.
I shouldn't be here. I'm innocent.
So you said before.
It's true. I was nowhere near the place when it was broken into.
Really?
I swear. Look, I'm innocent, Mr.
Fletcher. As I told you, it's up to the court to decide whether you're innocent or not.
Mr. Fletcher, can I have a word with you, please?
Wait there, Parks.
Did you authorize the search of Smith's cell?
No, why?
It's been ransacked.
What?
Yeah, and according to Smith, the tape's gone.
Well, if we didn't search the cell, it must have been one of the women, which means we're back to square one.
That's right.
Find out what you can, will you? Let me know.
All right.
Come on, Parks. You're in here.
Am I going to be in here all by myself?
Yeah, for the time being. Now I suggest that you make your bed and make yourself...
What are the other women like?
You'll find out soon enough. Now make your bed. You better get used to taking orders, Parks.
Yes, Mr. Fletcher.
I don't suppose you know anything about Smith's cell being ransacked.
Searched.
Pardon?
I organized a search.
You what?
Terry, there was no point in beating around the bush. If Smith had that tape, as she claimed, then it had to be found.
You did that knowing Mrs. Davidson's attitude.
I don't happen to agree with her soft peddling attitudes.
Oh, I know that. If Smith kicks up a stink, we've had it. How could you be so stupid?
I only did it to help you.
I'm in enough trouble without you trying to help me. Oh, Vera, I didn't mean that. Come on. Look, I know you're trying to help me. I appreciate that. But you went about it the wrong way. I'm sorry. Did you find the tape?
It wasn't there. Just as I thought, there was no duplicate. Terry, there was no duplicate tape, just contraband, biscuits, coffee, sugar.
Is this all the stuff you confiscated?
Some of it.
Where's the rest?
Well, I took it to the store. Now, Terry, you're wasting your time.
Ah-ha!
Oh, Terry, that's it.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to play it first, but I think that's the dreaded duplicate. Well, there's one resignation I won't have to sign. Vera, you're a marvel.
Oh, Terry.
Afternoon, all?
Yeah, afternoon. A bit late in the afternoon for you to be here, isn't it?
Well, I lost a lot of time when I had the flu, so I thought I'd catch up on a few cases in D block.
What do you know? Postcard from Hong Kong.
Anna?
How did you know?
Well, I got one, too. What does yours say?
Oh, just thanking me for showing around the prison. Nice of her to remember, though.
Well, it's the little things that count.
Yeah, oh, by the way, have you seen Vera lately?
No, why?
Well, you wouldn't believe the difference in her. She's all sweetness and light.
What's happened?
Terry Harrison, that's what's happened.
You're joking?
No.
Well, if Vera's happy, I'm very pleased for her.
I know exactly what you mean.
Well, I must get on and see my girls.
Yeah, look, any chance you'd be seeing Michelle Parks?
Well, who's she?
Our new arrival, accused of taking some funds from her employer. Of course, she didn't do it.
Well, she's pleading innocent.
Yeah, I was framed.
Well, she could have been, you know.
Yeah, well, anyway, is she likely to be one of your girls?
Well, not unless she's sentenced. I mean, I'd like to help them all, but I just haven't the authority.
Yeah, pity that. Make things a bit easier around here. They've been having a bit of a rough trot lately.
Well, is there anything in particular?
Yeah, Mrs. Davidson doesn't seem to think that we can run a prison properly.
Oh, Jim, that doesn't sound like her.
Yeah, I suppose I'm being a bit hard on her. What with the mother dying and everything.
What?
Didn't you know?
No.
Oh, yeah, Mrs. Mann died last night.
Is Erica in her office?
No, she went home early.
Oh, dear, I must phone her. She must be feeling dreadful.
Oh, when did you breeze in?
Just before.
Well, welcome to our humble home.
Thanks.
What's your name?
Michelle Parks.
I'm Judy Bryant. This is B. Smith.
What are you in for?
Nothing. I mean, I didn't do it.
Well, what is it you didn't do? Oh, no, one thing you have to learn about here, love, is there are no secrets. Got it?
Well, it's all such a mess. I don't know where to start.
Come on, love. What were you charged with?
Breaking and entering, theft of $8,000.
Ever done anything like that before?
I told you I didn't do it.
Well, what happened?
I was a secretary with this mail order company. Pretty small place, but I had a good position.
Go on.
Boss had a couple of restaurants, too. You know, tax reasons.
Ah, shady deals, eh?
Could have been. Seemed above board at the time. Anyway, there's a lot of work to get through. So the boss asked me to work late one night. I said I wouldn't. I wasn't trying to be difficult, but you see, I'm heavily involved in amateur athletics. And if I would have worked overtime, I would have missed my training.
No, the boss didn't agree, eh?
He sacked me. A week later, the place was burgled. I was out jogging at the time. I couldn't prove it.
Now, wait a minute, love. Anybody could have done it. How come they picked on you?
Well, it was an inside job. Someone would have had to have had a key.
Did you have one?
No. But since I'd left under a cloud, anyone else in the company had an alibi. I was the bunny.
That's tough.
Don't you believe me?
As far as we're concerned, it doesn't matter whether you're innocent or guilty.
It matters to me.
Like we said, welcome.
Don't worry, love. We'll see you after the muster bell. What do you reckon?
Ah, she could have been framed.
You don't believe her?
Pretty professional job for a kid her age.
Oh, you don't seem very interested.
Well, I've got other things in my mind, like who ransacked my cell, for instance.
Yeah, it's tough when you're losing all your goodies, love.
Yeah, say that again. What the hell? Looks like the cell fairy's been again.
Harrison.
Who else? You know, we might just have a real, live, decent screw on our hands for a change. Well, I suppose we shouldn't look a gift horse in the mouth.
Yes, sir, can I help you?
Henry Lawrence is the name. I'm here to see Michelle Parks.
Your family?
Closest thing to it, I'm her coach.
Her coach?
Her athletic coach. She's in training.
Really? What for?
Well, any luck, the 84 Olympics. I tell you, her name's already on the goals for the 400 and 800 metres.
Yes, you do realise that she's facing a very serious charge.
I certainly do. But with a bit of luck and a good lawyer, she'll be out in no time.
Yeah, I wouldn't count on that if I were you.
The girl's as honest as the day's long. The problem is there's an interstate meet next month. She's got to keep in training for that. Have you got facilities?
Well, no, not exactly.
A gym or something of the kind?
No, I'm afraid not.
Well, she's got to keep in training if she could run. You know, in the grounds, that'd be a start.
Yes, well, it's...
Look, I know it's none of your business. But that girl needs help. She only came to the city so she could train. She was peaking when all this business happened. She can't run. Well, she can kiss the Olympics goodbye.
I'll see what I can do for you.
Good man. Can I see you?
Yes, of course. You've just signed in here, please.
Right.
Can you pass me that bag?
It's Michelle's training gear.
So let's be searched, you know.
What? Oh. I was forgetting where I was. So keep your chin up and keep up your training while you're in here.
What's the use? Even if I could pay the bail, they're still going to convict me.
Says who?
You know I haven't got an alibi. There's no one to testify I was nowhere near the place when it was broken into.
What about the old lady?
She was just a darrow. Anyway, if she hasn't turned up by now, she's not likely to.
The police are still working on locating her.
The only thing they're working on is getting me convicted.
Remember that time you tore the ligament in your knee?
What about it?
No one gave you a hope in hell of ever competing again, not even me.
So?
But you did, didn't you? By thinking positive.
Thinking isn't going to get me off this rap.
It'll help. And in the meantime, we'll work on getting you a lawyer and bail.
That takes money.
You're entitled to legal aid, and the athletic club's raising the bail for you.
Fat chance they've got.
I've made inquiries, and the sooner you make application for a solicitor, the sooner you'll get out of here. Now, let's work on it, eh?
Yeah.
You'll get wrinkles.
What?
You're frowning. What's the matter?
Look, Terry, I don't want to talk shop, but you needn't have given Smith back her contraband.
Is it worth the wrinkles?
I just wish you hadn't, that's all.
Well, I stopped her making waves. Anyway, a few illicit luxuries aren't too much to pay.
Wentworth is a prison.
Not a holiday camp. Okay, tell you what. Why don't we agree to differ on that one? That's my girl. You know, you're not nearly as prickly as you used to be.
No.
I wonder why.
Well, it's a mystery, isn't it?
You happy?
Very. I'm so glad you didn't move out.
Yeah, so am I. I don't suppose there's such a thing as a perfect relationship, but, well, we're not doing too bad, are we?
No.
What now?
I'm just wondering where all this is leading.
Oh. Yes, I suppose you're thinking of something more permanent.
Well, yes, I suppose I am.
Marriage? What do you think of it? In theory, I mean.
I've always thought that if two people really cared about one another, then they should get married. It shows that they're serious and not just out for a good time.
I've always liked my freedom too much to think too much about permanency. To me, marriage always seemed a bit too permanent. But I've never felt like this for someone before. Maybe you're just the person to change my mind.
Whole block away for a minute. Now stop it.
I don't care.
Well, I do, so give it a rest.
Oh, it's easy for you to say, isn't it? My whole future's gone down the drain, and all you can say is give it a rest.
I'm not responsible for you being here.
Well, that makes two of us, but I'm here, aren't I?
Look, why don't you stop feeling sorry for yourself and take your coach's advice?
Oh, what would he know about being locked up?
Well, nothing, maybe. But he does have your best interest at heart. You going to keep training?
There's no facilities. I asked the women.
Well, you can still run.
I need someone to pace me. Can't imagine any of those slobs going out.
I'll pace you.
Oh, I'd leave you for dead. You're as unfit as they are.
Oh, no, I run a couple of miles a day, morning and night, rain, hail, or shine.
You're kidding?
No, I keep myself pretty fit. I've got no idea the trouble I went through to try and introduce phys ed into this place. But most of the women would prefer to sit on their bums and watch television.
Yeah, well, that's the trouble with most people. They complain about all sorts of things, but if they'd only get out into the fresh air a bit.
Why don't you give them a good example, eh?
Yeah, I'm not interested.
You've got a lot to learn, Parks.
It's none of your business.
Well, that's where you're wrong. It is my business. You haven't got many choices now you're on the inside, you know.
What do you mean?
You've got to take orders in this place. And if you don't, we've got ways of making life very unpleasant for you.
What are you getting at?
You start training tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock sharp. Make sure you've got your running gear on.
And if I'm not?
That's an order, Parks.
Well, that was about as good as a kick in the head.
Well, at least it's keeping you fit.
Yeah, it's all right for a limbering up exercise. I've got to get down to serious training. I get dizzy running 10 miles in this space.
Listen, are you serious about this?
I'm serious, all right.
All right, how'd you like to go outside?
You're kidding.
No, not right outside, but, well, that's just the inner fence. There's another fence further out, a perimeter fence. It'd have an overall perimeter of about a mile, I suppose.
That sounds better.
All right, I'll see what I can arrange for you. After all, there's still 10.5-foot barbed wire fence between you and freedom. You're not training for the high jump by any chance, are you?
You've forgotten your uniform.
What?
No, I've been training with Parks.
Yes, I saw you with Little Miss I Never Did It. Surely all this puffing and blowing's a little bit undignified for the deputy governor.
Put a sock in it, will you, Vera?
And what has Parks got that, say, Smith or Bryant haven't got.
What are you driving at?
You hardly need me to tell you the dangers of getting personally involved with an inmate.
I'm well aware of the dangers, Vera, don't worry. But since Erica is so keen on breaking down the barriers between staff and inmates, I thought it might be a good idea.
Do you really think she's got the ability to get to the Olympics?
Well, a coach certainly thinks so. But even if she doesn't, it makes more sense for her to keep fit than to be lounging around like all the others.
Yes, I couldn't agree more.
Oh, where have you been in that gear?
Training. What? I've been running around the barbecue area with Mr. Fletcher.
Ho, ho!
What do you mean?
Well, they don't call him Fletch the Letch for nothing, do they?
No. What are you getting at?
Well, he's not bad as screws go, but he has been known to take a personal interest in some of the girls.
Oh, no worries. There's nothing like that.
Mm. Yeah, well, that's what you think, but what does he think?
Listen, the relationship's purely physical.
Oh,
physical training, that is.
Yeah.
No, listen, he's even off to take me for a run outside the fence later.
Outside?
Outside the first fence, that is. He reckons the round distance is about a mile. Not a bad run.
Mm, especially if you go on a straight line.
What? Oh, yeah.
Freedom, here I come.
Yeah, watch it, Parks.
What's the trouble, Ted?
Well, Mr. Fletcher, this young lady wants to make a visit.
No, I'm sorry, it's too near dinner time. We'll have to come back another day.
Could I speak to somebody in authority?
I'm the deputy governor here.
Oh, listen, I've come from interstate. It'll only take a few minutes.
Who do you want to see?
Judy Bryant.
All right, I suppose Bryant gets few enough visitors. You'll have to make it snappy, though.
Thanks. I really appreciate it.
Right, just report to reception through there.
Thank you.
Come on, then.
That's best you can do?
I don't know where you're at.
Holding back, are you?
Yeah, that's right.
You mean you can really pace me?
Yeah, of course I can.
Okay, full bore.
You're on.
Got any sense, she'll do like I suggested and run a straight line.
That's a bit risky, isn't it? She's still got to get over the fence.
Oh, I don't know. If she's as good an athlete as she reckons she is, getting over the wire shouldn't be any problem.
Well, hard at it, are we, ladies?
I don't know about you, but we're doing all right.
I'm glad to hear it. Bright?
What have I done now?
Nothing. You got a visitor.
What?
A visitor. Well, come on, I haven't got all day.
Well, who is it?
Well, the sooner you get out of here, the sooner you'll know, won't you?
Probably someone from the voluntary visiting service. They've checked the records and found you haven't had a visitor for months.
In that case, I'm not going.
Suit yourself.
Oh, come on, Jude. A visitor's a visitor.
What, are you coming or not?
Oh, bloody do-gooders.
All right, girls, come on back to work. Let's get this finished before Doreen gets here with the next lot.
Bill, have you seen Parks? The runner, have you seen her? And have you seen Parks?
Who?
Parks, the runner.
Oh, you mean your Olympic athlete?
Look, stop mucking about, Ted. Have you seen her or not?
Bit of a panic merchant, aren't you, Mr. Fletcher?
How long have you been here?
About 5 minutes.
Yeah, about that long.
Check your stopwatch if you don't believe me.
How long has she been here?
About 5 minutes, easily.
Well, that means you've run the mile in about 5 minutes flat.
I usually do it in about 4:40.
Hi. Hello. Well, you're not from the voluntary visiting service, are you?
The what?
Voluntary visiting service.
Oh, no.
I didn't think so. I mean, you didn't look like one of those blue-rinsed do-gooders, huh?
No.
Well, who are you?
You are Judy Bryant, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm Judy Bryant. What's wrong, love? What do you want?
Look, this is going to sound really silly if I'm wrong, but I was wondering...
Go on.
I think you could be my mother.